Hey guys, so today I'm gonna be filming a redo for a foundation that I've reviewed for a long time ago before I even had this camera. It's a really old video and I don't actually remember, I should just watch it back honestly, how I feel about this foundation. So I thought it'd be a good idea to redo it because it's a very popular foundation for oily skin. It's the Hourglass Immaculate Foundation. This is a liquid to powder foundation. It's a little pricey, it retails for $55. There's 16 different shades and it's supposed to apply as a liquid, set as a powder, and just last all day and keep you shine free. So I remember I had a hard time figuring out what shade I was in, and I think that kind of like threw off everything. I'm not sure how I applied it, but when I think back to myself, I can't remember if I like it or not. Every other foundation I review, I know exactly, so I really wanted to redo this. So I was reading the instructions as far as how it's recommended to be applied, and it's recommended to use the Hourglass Veil Mineral Primer that's oil-free, and I love this primer. I've used it a lot. It's pretty pricey as well. It's pretty much like the same price, and if you use these two together, I can imagine this should only be used for special occasions because it's kind of a pricey combo. It's also recommended to not apply with a sponge, either use a brush or your fingertips, so that's what we're gonna try today. I hope I really didn't use a sponge before, I don't know, but let's give it a go. I'm using shade Nude, and this seems to be the closest one for me. It's the 7th shade out of 16. It's supposed to be a light medium, and it seems like kind of golden and yellowy. The packaging is basically like a very heavy-duty, heavy pump, and the pump comes detached originally. Like, you have to put the pump in yourself, kind of like mascaras, where you just take off like a sealed top and then put the pump in, or the wand. So it's not a very, very watery foundation. It's just slowly dripping down my hand, nothing too crazy. Brush-wise, it seems to recommend a dense, like curved one, so I'm gonna use this one from Beauty Junkies. This is their Pro Sculptor. It's one of their new brushes, and it's available on Amazon. So I have the Veil Primer on half of my face. This side is primed and this side is not, so we're gonna see if it wears differently. We're gonna apply this onto the primed side. And because it's liquid to powder, it's gonna set really fast, so work in small sections. I'm also gonna apply this with a brush on this side just to see, you know, primer, no primer, and then I'll do half my forehead with my fingers, etc., etc. Okay. So now all that's left is the forehead. From just that, it does look like it applied smoother on the prime side. I mean, both have a really, really good finish. I almost can't tell, but I feel like the foundation went a longer way on this side than it did on this side. I'm not usually a fan of applying foundation with my fingers. It's not really my thing. Takes a lot more work actually to blend where the foundation meets with the other foundation. It's set so fast, like you get like 3 swipes. But luckily my forehead does not need a lot of coverage, so it's okay with the fingers. I just think a brush makes it easier, faster with the formulation, so I'm just gonna blend where it meets. Okay, so let's take a picture. As you can see in the picture, there is no white cast. I don't think there is any SPF at all in this foundation, so there's no worries as far as that goes. And the shade looks pretty good. The finish looks good as well. It definitely looks like a soft powdered finish, not too cakey. It doesn't look shiny in any area that I have to worry about, so we'll see how it holds up. I'll give you guys a starting point picture, and then I'll see you guys at the end of the day. Hey guys, so I just finished wearing the foundation for about 7 hours and I am kind of impressed. I don't remember, like I said, how I felt about it, but as far as a foundation that I did not have to wear powder with, it still feels really good on the face. I don't feel like I'm dripping oil. I think it's still doing its job. I think the side that has primer looks a little bit better. I mean, just a little bit, as far as if you have like combo skin, you have some dry areas, I think the primer helps a lot for that, because I had just a tiny dry patch here that didn't look as good as possibly some dry patches over here. So it's not a must, but it can make your foundation look a little better, last a little longer, and if you have dry patches, I think it would help with that. But otherwise, the coverage is still there. I think the coverage is a good medium, almost leaning to full. It has a good amount of coverage, and I like the texture. It feels very light on the face. I'm happy that this shade actually works. Like, I would wear this again, and I definitely would keep this in my foundation like arsenal as far as like a day that's not super hot. So it's only like 70 degrees right now. It's not hot. It was a lot hotter other days. It's like raining and it's gloomy, so it's not as like bad as it usually is, and this foundation held up really well. I would wear it on similar weather days, so this would be great for me in the fall, like ending of summer and maybe into winter. I don't really know, but I like it. I don't have a problem with it as far as like being in my fine lines or into my pores. I think the only area that I have a greasy issue with is around my nose right here. This I can feel is getting tacky, so I would either set this area well with powder, like in the crease area, like wherever like a lot of foundation builds up, and maybe do a little on my like T-zone. But right here isn't getting too bad. This side is getting a little oily, like where I have concealer on, but this side isn't, because I think it's the drier side because I didn't put primer on. So I would either maybe wear it without a primer if I don't have any dry patches, or set just this area maybe like right there and leave everything else be, because it looks good. It doesn't look cakey on, and I like it. I like how it wears. I don't like the price tag, but I definitely feel like I had a better experience this time around than last time because of the whole shade conundrum. So if we usually match in shades, nude is your shade in this foundation. So I hope you guys enjoyed hearing my thoughts about this foundation. I will be doing a new release for Makeup Forever next as far as foundation reviews go. So thumbs up if you're excited for that, or if you enjoyed this video. Thank you guys as always for watching. Please comment, rate, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in a later video.